Welcome. It's nice to have you here. I'm so glad you could come. This is going to be such an exciting day. I hope you enjoy it. I think you will.
Who remembers this? Yeah? What is it? Willy Wonka. And yeah, I know the most sessions that I attended at this conference was one slide and then go to the demo, but this will be a different one. One. Yep. So a bit of a story and the programming in my mind that I create and the programming that I write. It's a bit different. And also for the story in my head, it's awesome and like Jurassic Park and all that kind of things. But hey, when I write it down or make a presentation, it feels like little dino without internet connection. I never created an escape room before, so I think I definitely be able to do that. Pippi Langstocking, that's Pippi Langkous in Dutch. We all know that one, right? Yep. Okay. Professional testers. My escape room was tested by the most critical professional tester. Anyone can guess who? The kids. And okay. Let's take a step back because it's a strange introduction, but yeah, we can also create a standard introduction. What tells this about me? You can take the picture now, but at the end, this QR code and also the QR code for the evaluation form will be on it, so no worries. I'm a volunteer at Coda Dojo, which is a voluntary organization of to teach kids how to program. And yeah, that's something that kids sometimes like to do. My name is Michiel Hamers, so I found it really funny to say over here. We are with the four of us, two kids, and yeah, one is a bit different. I have two sons and the wife, which is, of course, the other way around. I live in a small city called Oz. So in my opinion, there is stated Microsoft loves Oz. I don't want to hear something about open source or something. And I work at a company called Ordina, and I have to wear this shirt, make a picture, then they allow me to travel around the world. Okay, fair enough trade-off, but that's enough for my office or company. If you want to know more, you can look me up. That's no problem, but yeah. Story is everything. And I'm not really good at storytelling. However, it is everything. I already mentioned about my professional testers. Do you know how... Yeah, let me first ask another question. Who already has done an escape room? Performed Yep. And how often do you go to the same escape room? Once. So if I create an escape room, my kids are in the most positive way happy once. Yeah, and that's the most positive way. My kids say, hey, no game, no life. And that brings me also a bit to as we have in the Netherlands a party or a celebration day, or just how you want to call it. It's called in the Dutch Sinterklaas, which is almost the same as Santa Claus, but it's in December, but it's the 5th. It's a party for kids, they get presents, and there are also some things about it that I don't want to talk about over here, because it has some strange thing, but hey, I will talk about the kids and the presents. They like presents, and a couple of years ago, I thought, maybe it's nice to don't just say the presents are over there, but make a puzzle. A hint on a note or something, where the presents are. However, you like codes. I mean, presents are nice, but you want to at least see a bit of code or understand a bit what I really did. I used PowerShell as a backend. So for that improvement version of giving the kids presents, where I first put all the presents in a room, locked that room, not the kids, but I locked the room. So it's recorded, so I don't want to say I locked my kids. So that's, I locked the presents, and then I created a back-end system. And yeah, with PowerShell. And no, I'm not saying that's the best way, but hey, I had, how do you say that? At the time, I almost had barely none experience in PowerShell. However, I wanted to learn more PowerShell. And at the same time, I want happy kids, but also create something as a side project for my home, because sometimes I get voices in my head, or voices that my wife says to me, you need to spend more time with your kids, or at least do some good things, and not only work. And I thought maybe it's a good combination to learn PowerShell, and then the end result will be happy kids. I tried, learn, improve, and progress. But for this try, learn, improve, that's a pretty difficult thing if you're doing an escape room, which you only can perform once. So I first create a whole monolith. I'm saying that correct in English? Yeah, monolith, yep. And then, yeah, I learned a lot, but they didn't test it right. And then the kids were happy. They get, in the end, an Xbox. However, during the steps, a slot, you have a key, slot, lock, sorry, stupid, lock. One lock, which was a combination of numbers, and I did everything okay, I was thinking. However, I swapped the red lock and the blue lock. That's funny, because the kids had the, according to my schedule, the code right, but I put in the wrong lock on the... Yeah. And what I learned, that this is an awesome technical design. However, can anyone see what is wrong with this kind of design when you are trying to create an escape room? Escape rooms and everything what you do in this kind of matter should not have a relation with cloud. Or at least have a fallback, fail safe, plan B, whatsoever. Because a couple of computers, a NAS, and some bad connection to the cloud, that makes it really, of course, then my internet provider will go down for just an hour during the 30 minutes that you need to have the escape room running. It's not really convenient. Also not to explain, hey, didn't you oversee that? That's not the kind of words that you want to hear. Don't ask me how I know. However, I learned every year, and yes, every year they still get presents. They already know it's a made-up story, but it's still, they get presents. Yeah. You don't have to read it, but it's just an example list. I just sent out all the machines that I have, like a notebook, and yeah, I had some Surface RT device, and so several systems, a Raspberry Pi, a Microbit, a Beamer, all things that I have. So when you are going to download the my example of what I all created for the escape room, yeah, it will run the best if you have exactly the same, but that's not what I'm talking about. It's not about the same. You don't have to build exactly the same. It's what you already have, because you are not going to build a 1,000, 10,000 euro escape room. Yeah, maybe it's a good business case, but I decided to show you a bit of it while running. However, I don't have all the things over here. Let me check if that's working. And you can see, for the good watchers, you can fake it.
Welcome to your escape room. Please note that all the members will be forbidden to leave the room until all tasks are complete. If you have an emergency or concern, please consult one of your room guides. Best of luck. You have precisely 30 minutes to complete the following task.
Awesome. So, and that goes on and on. But, yeah, of course we are not going to watch 30 minutes of countdown. It would be easy for preparing, right? If I would just do that. I have, and I know that you cannot read it. I know. I'm not going to zoom in. It's not really needed to zoom in. Just understand that I create a couple of years ago, with the experience from then, a main PS1, so main PowerShell, where I can control everything that I want. I can control everything, I can exit, I can stop and reset, I can use this computer, because this window, you have to see that as an own computer, and so I have 1, 2, 3, 4 computers. Yeah, that's pretty understandable, yep. So if I open here the same, and maybe you already see I all everywhere now use main. However, normally on the other computers, you will use screen.ps1. But of course, there's some bugs in it. And when you run main and then you start up a screen, it doesn't have bugs. So I will show you. Without showing bugs, use as a screen, numlock needs to be on. This one is screen one, already a winner, great. Also a screen, that's screen number two, screen, and that's screen number three. And I hope that I can reset my escape room now just on this way, I hope. So it will in the end probably just all go to. So nothing fancy. The kids will not really go to open a keyboard or use a keyboard to work everything and then escape special things. It's about challenges and about quests. As you can see over here, this system at the top left corner has really nice ASCII art. That is auto-generated and cached. So it comes from an API and it's just downloading based on what you are using. And then it caches and creates its own escape room ASCII art file, caches it, and if you use it for another thing that you want to present with ASCII art, you just can type in something different than it will the first time need to have internet connection. After that, it's just using the cached version. You can simply show the config. It's a timer on 30. Other configurations are, of course, global variables, because that's the best thing to do. Now, that's not the best thing to do, but it's there, right? I can reset it. I can, as you can see over here now, it has also stating a status message, and then I can just say, okay, start with 42. Why 42? Yeah. So, and then after that, I learned that I don't want to start it immediately, because my kids won't just start when I say they have to start. So I added an wait, sort of. And I call that 42 USB. It's starting now, and one screen. Escape room stated upstairs, and that image and there. Attach the data bar on to start the escape room. Yeah, it's in Dutch. Sorry. I thought maybe it's difficult if I get all my stuff over here from whole my house to over here to really build up an escape room. That was a bit difficult. So I am really old and I know tricks. One of the trick is subst. Everyone knows subst? No. Who doesn't know the command subst? Who doesn't know? Don't be afraid. No? Subst? Okay. Subst is that you can substitute a drive letter, in this case E, and then with the current folder as drive. So it will maps what's in C source ER to a fake drive letter E. When you go to in the Windows Explorer, it will just show up, and then it will also show that folder with that special thing. When I go back now to this screen, it will say it is attached, and it is counting down. In Dutch, they stated this is the main screen. At this main screen, there is no keyboard attached. Simple. At screen 2, what's the amount of Harry Potter books? Now, let's fill that out. 7. It's correct. As you can see over here, it's going continuously to another quest as the quest is now continuing. It's not rocket science what I programmed. It does the job. If I only want to let the kids, because kids do sometimes crazy stuff, if I only want to get input like a numeric value, there's an easy way to ensure that they only can enter numeric value. Any suggestions? Indeed, just add a numpad. And that can be an attached physical one, but I have a wireless thing, so I can place that on a special place, and it's almost looking like a professional way. And that's not too expensive. Same count for these kind of things, just on Amazon, and then you can just read out the input, and you can also program that in your Quest JSON. Okay, as we have the 63 slides edition, we also need to go back to the slides. So that's a difficult one. Let's just say this one. Can you open the lock using these clues? And I'm not sure if it's readable enough. Someone? If you know it, it just shout. I can wait all day. And let me make it more convenient for you all. Zero something two. And you are in a room with a lot of nerds, at least I am. So what will it be? Correct. Yep. Yeah, it's just 0, 4, 2. One digit right in the right place. One digit is right but in the wrong place. Two digits are right but both are in the wrong place. And of course, I grabbed this off the internet. Yeah, and that's also something magical. If you want to create something like this, just use a lot of tools that are out there. Same kind for this one. And these kind of things are really easy to implement as a quest. You still need to add that up to a story. Let's make it easy. Ox, beer, TV, love. It's not PowerShell because that would be too easy. Okay. As this takes a lot of time already, so you know that sometimes a couple of quests is enough to entertain or create an escape room really right away. It's Expel's Life, by the way. Also, this kind of mazes, you can generate this. You can print this out, and you can just place it somewhere hidden with a clue where to look. And then USB stick can be found in the radio of someone's in this house. It ends where it started. So and yeah, the whole path is in there, but I thought my PowerPoint skills were pretty good, but I ended up with messing with the Markov file, so I didn't dare to try that again as my, it's maybe next time. You can, someone's, okay, sure. You can create special logos and rebrand it. You can use URLs to create some cryptography. There are a lot of tools out there. If you download, if you go to my GitHub, you see also in this presentation all those links where you can just click on it and then go to those tools. Will this work? Probably. I'm not sure if Morse is in the English what the pronunciation is, but Morse yeah, code will do. So, it's an easy one. My kids could solve this one, but I will help. It's just PowerShell. And you can generate this just by going to that URL and just print out a Morse code. Or maybe you don't even have to, because at least in the Dutch dictionary, in the end of the Dutch dictionary, there is a translation of this. It's really, it's stated in the regular Dutch dictionary, probably, maybe in some English dictionaries too. Creating ASCII art is really also fun to do. So sometimes I do it manually, which can also just generate it. And you can also use services like CAD as a service. And every time that this page will be loaded, it will present the text that you provide with the with a cat. Other things that you can do to create a point in the GPS system is with three words. And if you use that and you let kids use the computer to look that up, and you are a bit into gaming and puzzling, that steak bronze supply, three words, can give you 4-digit number. So I know that this is a bit difficult. Let's try. Staked bronzer supply. What three words? What was it? Staked? Bronzer? Supply. Let me show a bit, zoom a bit out, because then you understand I'm looking at a Google Maps or whatsoever, a map plan. With three words, you can identify 1 square meter all over the world. If you zoom in at that place, and you are searching for a 4-digit number, and you look around, and maybe I should tell this location is part of the Efteling, which is like Disneyland, however, prettier, more stories. And there is a roller coaster, which is called Baron 1898, which is a Baron 1898. Yep, they have to puzzle. And you can, of course, make it more difficult or easy. But an easy way to identify a GPS location all over the world. And that's a bit of combination of, I love geocaching. And with geocaching, also sometimes you have some strange puzzles, and I reuse that because I already know that a bit. You can and you should use what you already have. So don't just say, I just download that one and apply it, because that won't work. And use things that you already have in-house, like the remote. Who has already a remote at house, some such thing? Yeah, a couple of people, yeah. It's a Bluetooth device. If you just go and buy some, wood, and then build that remote in that wood with only the A button that you can see, you have a mobile button that's connected to your computer that you just can read from your input. Nothing fancy. And then how difficult can it be? You have one remote and you create four exactly the same boxes, then they have to look at the right place. When you have four remotes and four same boxes and you only power one, then they have to press the right button. It's not that difficult. I like sometimes adding GIF files to the screens, because yes, it's a PowerShell thing, but you can just invoke a web browser and then open an image. If you use one of those things that you need internet for, just ensure that if that's not working, that an alternative will be displayed. Store is everything. And you may say, that's simple. But a lot of people went to this room and didn't choose to sit where they normally should sit, just because it was on the story, right on slide one, there was, come, sit that out. That works with kids too. That works almost with everyone. Just provide them clear instructions and it works. But plan B saves a lot. And plan B, in case when you are creating an escape room, is create at least a walkthrough with all steps in it, and one with answers. And you can say, there are just 10 things to check. No. Believe me, you should do that. And at that walkthrough, you also need to state, for example, the red lock needs on that bag. The blue lock needs to be at that bag. Hence, I know. What you see over here in small is Brian. When people cannot see, then can feel points, but you can also use it as an encryption or something that needs to be looked up. Make a floor plan based on how big is your house, or your office, or a couple of your office rooms. Make it, because that makes it easier to understand how your flow will be, how the flow, and via that way, you are not over-programming. Because I was really, over here, I had a computer in the room which held the waiting state right after that I started the escape room. And all the kids were at the other floor. And when they solved somewhere there, then it switched to something different. Why? I don't know. That was programming technical it was logic to have it in a sort of wait state, but yeah, sometimes it even doesn't have to be connected to the other system. Well, that depends on your floor plan, on your escape room program, what you want to achieve. And yes, it's only for 30 minutes max. A lot of work, a lot of learning. I created also, and you don't have to, for each room, and no, you don't have to read it, but for each room, what the setup is, what the story is behind, what I need to set in the room related to the story. That's, I like to be prepared. So, and you even can go as much, so far as much as you like, but I have used the Roald Dahl story, Charlie and Chocolate Factory, once. You all know that one, sorry. That background music is one of the things that I've learned that's not fun when it's when you are struggling with a puzzle, unless you really want to give mental issues to your kids. So please try, if you are going to set up this for your kids, for your colleagues, for your friends, for whatsoever, yes, make it challenging, but be also a bit of kind, or at least ensure that you are going to have the opportunity to change it a bit during the session. And one of the things that I used, because my kids not always like my voice, I use a voiceover for the movies that I use within the escape room. I have an example for that later. Create a real golden ticket, for example, and at the back and at the end of the backwards of the golden ticket, you can, for example, say, this is how you can start the escape room. Then it makes, you can give that right away. And after a week or so, it's the day that the escape room will be. So it makes it a bit story and it helps. However, how often do you meet your professional deadline? How often, like in percentages? Is it 100% for you? Everyone 100%? No, eh? No. So sometimes you can also choose for changing to a bit of fake it until you make it. What I did was a Surface tablet sitting next to the big screen, which had the PowerShell code on it to present something automatically. However, this screen was on the main screen, and then I just entered the button. For every time that they finished a room, I make it or vanished or colored. Now I made it colored, but I messed it up in PowerPoint. Sorry for my PowerPoint skills. So it was, that part was done. So that I took that completely out of the PowerShell part, because I need, when it's 5th of December, that is the day for the presents. Not 6th, not 7th, 5th. And believe me, you cannot buy time with professional testers. So Morse code is an easy thing to create, but difficult to solve. Use friends if you want to try it out with your colleagues to check how much time this will cost for playing. Use hints that are logical for your users. Rabobank is one of the banks in Netherlands. But over here it stated it's the present is below bank, which is in Dutch below the couch. It's And I'm not sponsoring anything, so all the other banks are good. One of the things that I also do, and yeah, it's recorded, but...
Gefeliciteerd. Je hebt de USB-stick gevonden.
Sorry. That was the real audio in Dutch. Hey, happy, you found the USB stick. And yeah, that is me. I use therefore a snap filter, a Snapchat filter. Record it, but don't use my own voice. Then it makes fun. It needs to be love as well. You know your user probably, so take that advantage. I left the screen blank, so no worries, because I failed a lot. I definitely failed a lot. However, at least when you have plan B, and good overview what your quest and the answers and the locks are, you cannot really fail, because you can assist in a way, at least the first time, assist in a way, and oh, no, you tried it wrong. And then it's open. So, yeah, I failed. I also failed at the internet connection, but that was, yeah. I also failed at writing nice code, but it managed, it works. And when people, and yes, some colleagues tried it also, when people try to sabotage the escape room, then they are the losers. They are failing, really. That should be your mindset, because otherwise you are really make it too difficult for yourself, because then it will be professional and like work. If you like this kind of puzzles, maybe you're also interested in Project Euler. Don't you know? If you don't know that, go check that out. And also Advent of Code, really awesome to check. I check my GitHub for a version to make the screen and the Quest PS1 files for this presentation. And yeah, let's connect also after the session. Thank you.
That's all, folks.